गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड, दिस इज़ आवर सेकेंड वीडियो ऑफ सोर्सेस ऑफ एनर्जी। वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग आवर टॉपिक कन्वेंशनल सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी। नाउ टुडे वी विल कंप्लीट आवर कन्वेंशनल सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी, देन आफ्टर वी विल स्टार्ट इन आवर नेक्स्ट वीडियो नॉन कन्वेंशनल सोर्सेस ऑफ एनर्जी। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर रिमेनिंग टॉपिक्स, दैट इज बायोमास। वॉट इज बायोमास? The dead part of plants and trees and the waste material of the animal and man are called biomass. Means plants and animals that are decayed after dying, the waste products and the waste products of human beings and animals, leaves, vegetable peels, these all materials are called biomass. Example, wood, charcoal, cow dung and biogas. These are the examples of biomass. That is, first, charcoal. What is charcoal? When wood is burnt in limited supply of air, then water and other volatile material gets removed and charcoal is formed. Means when we burn the wood, then after some time when limited supply of air we have given, then a charcoal is formed. Means the black ashes that are remaining after burning of wood, that is called charcoal. Then charcoal is better fuel than wood. Means we are considering charcoal is better than wood. And charcoal is a byproduct of wood. When wood was burned, then after we get charcoal. But charcoal is better fuel than wood. Why? Because it has higher calorific value than wood. Means wood, the amount of energy released by the wood after burning is lower than the amount of energy given by a charcoal. That's why charcoal has good and better fuel than wood, because his calorific value is very high than wood. And second, it does not produce smoke while burning. When we burn the wood, we saw that so many harmful smokes and gases released in our atmosphere. But when we burn the charcoal as a fuel, it doesn't give us any harmful smokes, doesn't produce it. That's why it is good fuel. It is a compact fuel, easy to handle and convenient to use. Means it is safe when we are using, and it is easy to handle. But when we use wood, so if the temperature rises, then it is hard to lower the temperature of wood. But in charcoal, it is convenient to use. That's why it is a better fuel than wood. Understand? Now, our next topic is biogas. And biogas is also an example of biomass. Okay? It is produced in a biogas plant. Means from where we get biogas? From biogas plants. How it is formed? Anaerobic microorganisms decomposes the complex compound of the cow dung plus water slurry. It takes few days for. Means when we put and dig the soil, then after we dump the waste products that we are getting from our household, means cow dung and all this, mostly cow dung and their water slurry, we will put in a dig. When we dig the soil, we will put in them, and we also make a biogas plants. We put the cow dung and water slurry in that, then the microorganisms will decompose the cow dung, and for few days after, the gas released when the cow dung decompose and the biogas we will get. And the gas that was come when cow dung will decompose, like methane, CO2, hydrogen and hydrogen sulfide. These are the gases released when decomposition process is going on in biogas plants. And these are called the biogas, and this biogas is stored in gas tank and above the digester. And the digester from which they are drawn through pipes for use. Then after we will separate the gas from the remaining products and we will get the biogas for use. Now these are biomass and biogas, but there are advantages of biogas. What is that advantages? It is an excellent fuel as it contains up to 75% methane. Means in biogas, the value of the proportion of methane is very high, approximately 75%. So it is a good fuel, excellent fuel. It burns without smokes. When we use for cooking purpose and for other purpose as a fuel, biogas, and it doesn't produce, when it burns, it doesn't produce smoke. So it is an eco-friendly gas. So it is a good fuel. Leaves no residue like as in wood and coal burning. When we burn the coal and wood as a fuel at our home to make a food for anything, after it burns, there remains some residue like ash. But when we use a biogas, it doesn't produce any residue. It is also used for lighting. So we will see at our village light lamp. When light goes, we use lamp. So biogas is also using for lighting. Slurry left behind is used as excellent manure, rich in nitrogen and phosphorus. So we produce biogas from what? To decompose cow dungs, right? Then cow dung decomposes by microorganisms, then after we will get biogas. So the remaining residue of cow dung we are using as a manure because it is high rich in nitrogen and phosphorus like elements and it is good for soil. So as a manure we are using the residue of biogas. Now, safe and efficient method of waste disposal. So we will convert the waste product in for our purposes. So it is the best waste disposal method to convert waste into to use again. Now, and our next conventional source of energy is wind energy. Wind energy is a process to convert mechanical energy into electrical energy by the means of wind. Means where the rate of speed of wind is approximately 10 to 15 to 20 kilometer per hour, we will made their wind wind energy plants to produce wind energy, means mechanical energy, to convert mechanical energy into electrical energy. So it refers to the process of generating electrical energy by means of wind turbines. It is a type of solar energy that transforms the kinetic energy of the wind to mechanical power. Means in this process, like solar energy, we are using sunlight for making mechanical to electrical energy. In that also same cases we are using kinetic energy. What is kinetic energy? Energy possessed by moving is called kinetic energy. When anything are moving, we get energy, and that type of energy is called kinetic energy. So in wind energy, the wind turbine will rotate and it get moving faster, and kinetic energy is increases. So the energy convert into mechanical energy into electrical energy. In this way we are using wind energy as a sources of our energy. In areas which are very windy, means I told you right now, the areas where winds are continuously moving at 20 kilometer hour as a speed, where it is constantly द रेट ऑफ एनर्जी रेट ऑफ स्पीड वॉज कॉन्स्टेंट सेम वेयर वी इन दैट एरिया वी विल विंड मिल्स वी विल स्टैंडिंग एंड सपोर्ट एंड कंस्टेबल हाइट. द मिनिमम विंड स्पीड फॉर विंड मिल टू सर्व एज अ सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी इज 15 to 20 किलोमीटर पर आवर. दिस इज नोन एज विंड एनर्जी फार्म. मीन्स वी मेक अ विंड एनर्जी फार्म एट इन दैट एरिया वेयर द रेट ऑफ स्पीड वॉज 15 to 20 किलोमीटर पर आवर. And approximately the land we are using for wind energy farm is 2 hectares. Now, and there are some advantages and disadvantages of wind energy. And the advantages of wind energy: it is environment friendly, means we doesn't get any harmful things, harmful gas and harmful things that get polluted our environment. And it is, that's why it is an advantages of wind energy. It is environment friendly. Efficient source of renewable energy means it is never be end. So we get always we get a energy, means we can reuse the energy, we can use in same time different purposes. Only construction expense is involved, but the maintenance is less. So if we want to make a wind energy farm, so it was the cost is very high, but after that the maintenance is very less. So it is efficient and it is cheap. Only construction was high rate, but the maintenance is very less. So it is the advantages of wind energy. But there are some disadvantages of wind energy, and that are: wind energy farms need large area of land. Recently we will study that the to make a wind energy farm approximately 2 hectares of land will have, but it is not possible everywhere to have such big land we have. So it is very difficult where air is constantly moving 15 to 20 kilometer per hour and we will get there a land. So it is disadvantages of wind energy: difficulty in getting regular wind speed of 15 to 20 kilometer per hour, and everywhere the speed of wind is not constantly at 15 to 20 kilometer per hour. So everywhere it is not possible to make a wind energy farm. An initial cost of establishing wind energy farm is very high. I told you the maintenance is low, but the construction prices and the initial cost of wind energy farm, to establish wind energy farm, is very high. So we did so everyone is not possible every for everyone to make a wind energy farm in every area. High level of maintenance of blades of windmill. So the maintenance is less, but after some year we have to change at same interval of time to change the wind blades, because the moisture, the atmosphere, the moisture will corrode the blade. So we have to change the blades in after three or four years. So it is, cost is very high. So it was the disadvantages of wind energy. So our conventional source of energy is completed. In our next video, we will continue with our non-conventional sources of energy. Thank you.